seized. If you guys enjoyed the intro or enjoy what you see here, go follow SM_battle_stories on Instagram or get some work done yourself. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, I have a brand new WWE Elite Fantasy Attire custom AJ Styles figure for you guys, and I'm totally psyched out about it. I'm very happy with the result, as you can see it right here, guys. I mean, my goodness gracious, I think it came out way better than I expected it to, and it's just very, I don't know, I'm very, very excited for the way it came out, and I'm going to go through, you know, the part selection, you know, the paints that I used here, and every single thing that I did to create this AJ Styles. But he may or may not be wearing this at MDT Sold Out. That was the whole reason I made it. I wanted to have AJ Styles in a custom, you know, fantasy sort of attire to rock at MDT Sold Out. So this may or may not be it. I don't know if I'm going to do it or not. I don't want it to get destroyed, you know, filming and posing and stuff. But I guess we'll have to see. I haven't sealed it yet either. So I do have to, you know, get in there and seal it up and make it all look nice. But before I do that, I do want to give a shout out to somebody for inspiring me to do this custom, because when I saw this person's custom, it made me, like, I don't know, it popped this idea to make this figure that you see in front of you. So let's go ahead. I want to give a huge shout out to Harrison from Fernando G Wang or Fernandog Wang on Instagram, and he has an amazing pick vet as well. And you guys should go subscribe to that. It is, just type in Harrison Pick Fed and it'll be the first thing that pops up. But he made a custom AJ Styles that I'll pop up on the screen for you guys. And it really just inspired, like, as soon as I saw his, I was like, oh yeah, Brad, I gotta get in here and I gotta make my own. So that is the result that you see here in front of you. And we're gonna take a zoom in shot here. But first I wanna go over the part selection. We did use the Elite 51 AJ Styles as the base. That is what you're looking at right here. But I had to switch out the neck peg. I switched out the neck peg with the Elite 56 AJ Styles. And then everything else from the torso, arms, and then the legs are all Elite 51 AJ Styles. And then for the kick pads, I had to use Elite 47 AJ Styles because my leftover, or one of my kick pads on my Elite 51 were all bummy. The foot broke off a while back, so I had to switch it out with Elite 47, and I came in and custom painted everything here. The hardest part, I think, for me was this blue color. I was going to go with a different color. If you guys saw my Instagram story yesterday, you would have seen that I, you know, I posted which color blue I should use, and it was like a Carolina blue and then sort of a greenish, like tealish blue. I don't really know how to describe it, but I used this blue, and I was worried to use this blue because I didn't know if it would pop enough off of the white to, you know, make a good contrasting color, but I think it works here at the end. I painted over all the black on the figure with the Elite 51 in the white to, you know, give it the main white trunks there. And then I switched out the knees with Shawn Michaels' knees. That way the knee joints wouldn't chip and stuff like that. I then came in and outlined all of the silver with black because I, like, painted over it with the white. Had to come back with the black, touch that up, and outline that. And then I came in with the blue, went over the silver, you know, sort of gave it like a three-tone, so or four-tone. You got white, silver, black, and the light blue color. You got the P1 logo right here. Really love the way that looks on the side right there. The P1 is painted blue. And then, of course, we got the designs on the back there. It's probably the fifth time you've seen it 360. If I apologize for that, but I just want you guys to see what we did there. I also painted up the gloves in the light blue color with the black on there. I was going to do black gloves and sort of do, like, is, you know, Fastlane and WrestleMania or whatever it was, attires, with the black with the light blue in the middle, but I wanted to switch it up. So I went with the Carolina blue gloves. And then on the kick pads, I came in, painted over the blue with this silver color, and then painted over the white with the light blue color. And I'm really happy with the way that came out. At first, I was going to do, you know, Carolina blue all over the kick pads, like back here and on the shoes right there. But I just figured this would work better. I really like the silver and Carolina blue with the black contrasting through. And that is pretty much it, except for the elbow pad. We did do the elbow pad. You got the cut elbow pad, and the P1 logo is the blue color. So I am very stoked. Again, very stoked with the way this came out. And I think I should use it at Sold Out. I think it would be really cool to see him battle CM Punk in this attire, so I guess we'll have to see. if that is what happens. But that pretty much does it for this custom figure, guys. That's this is basically what I was doing all day yesterday because I couldn't film the show if I didn't have the AJ Styles to work with, so I was working on this. But that pretty much does it for this video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys. And I just appreciate you guys so much for checking out the custom. Let me know down in the comment section below what you think. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.